In this example, we're going to use observational data that is simulated to find the causal effect of a hypothetical program on an outcome. And we're going to do this by drawing a DAG in dagitty, and then we'll use matching and inverse probability weighting to measure the causal effect in a couple of different ways using R. So let's go ahead and get started. So we'll start with dagitty first. This comes from the reading that you had, that the chapter in the R for political science book that I had you read. These are a whole bunch of different things that influence both mosquito net usage and the risk of malaria. So we're gonna quickly connect this DAG together so you can see what we need to control for. So we're gonna assume that we have all of these columns in a data set because I simulated it, so we do. But the story we're gonna tell is this causal graph here. We're gonna say mosquito net is our exposure. We want to see what the effect of having a mosquito net is on the risk of malaria, which is our outcome. So then we can start drawing arrows. We can say that using a mosquito net has an influence on the risk of malaria. This is the main arrow we care about. We want to isolate this arrow. But there are other things that influence either just mosquito net usage or just risk of malaria or both. So insecticide resistance in a region will influence the risk of malaria because it'll make it harder to get rid of mosquitoes. But that doesn't necessarily connect to mosquito net usage, and so we'll just connect it that way. Nighttime temperatures, if it's too hot at night, that's gonna make it harder to use a mosquito net, but that's also going to increase the risk of malaria. So we're going to connect nighttime temperatures to mosquito net and connect nighttime temperatures to risk of malaria. Income. If you're wealthier, you can afford a mosquito net, and if you're wealthier, you can afford medical care. So this program that we're talking about, this is kind of this program that distributes mosquito nets to people with low income and with lots of people in their household. And so program eligibility influences whether or not you can use a mosquito net. But in order to use this program, you have to have a specific level of income, so that causes eligibility, and the number in household also causes eligibility. And the number in household also causes the use of mosquito net. If there's only one person in your house and you can afford one net, then you're fine. If you have like six people in your house, you can only afford one net, then that's going to change your mosquito net usage. So we can draw an arrow there. And then finally, your underlying health can also influence whether or not you use a mosquito net and your general risk of malaria. Okay, so that's the story we're telling ourselves. We could be missing nodes, we could be missing arrows between different things, but we'll assume just for this example that this is correct and that this is our true causal diagram. And so according to the logic of due calculus, if we want to isolate this one arrow here, the effect of mosquito net on risk of malaria, we need to adjust for three things. It tells us that right here. We need to adjust for health, income, and nighttime temperatures. That's because those are all confounders. They all open up back doors between mosquito net and risk of malaria. So we can adjust for it in dagitty. If we click on the node, we can tell it to be adjusted. And we can tell income to be adjusted and nighttime temperatures to be adjusted. So what we're left with is a well-isolated and identified relationship between mosquito net and risk of malaria. We don't have to control for program eligibility. We don't need to control or adjust for number in household or insecticide resistance because those don't confound that relationship. The only things that do confound it are income, temperatures, and health. So according to this causal diagram, that is what we need to deal with. If we want to check to see if it's true, we have a whole bunch of testable implications where we can see if mosquito net usage is really independent of insecticide resistance. That arrow I kind of have some doubts about, actually, because if you know that there's no resistance and insecticide kills all the mosquitoes, you're probably not going to use the mosquito net. So I would guess that there's a correlation there, so that might not be true. But you can test that in your data. That should be true, that they're independent of each other. Insecticide resistance should be independent of health. That's probably true. You can go through and check all of these different testable implications. You can even click on show all and see the big list. But for the sake of this example, we won't do that. So that is our causal graph. We need to adjust for health, income, and nighttime temperatures if we want to isolate the relationship between mosquito net and risk of malaria.